guys. It is currently 5:30 in the morning. I'm leaving Phoenix, Arizona on my way to St. George, Utah. 28.1
miles ahead. Take first exit on US 93 north.
I am headed north on 60. Saying I should be there about 11:20, 11:30 in the morning. I wanted to get up early, get out there. I've been sick. I don't know if you guys can hear it in my voice, but it's been rough. Decided I would get out. Thought I wasn't that bad. I worked about a week and it put me down. I took off all, pretty much all this week and half of last week, so. It is Wednesday today. I believe it's the, I don't know, 9th or the 10th or, I don't know, you guys ever get lost in your days when you're out here trucking? I feel like that's kind of the norm. Half the time I don't know what the day it is. I don't know what the date. You just go to work every day and just keep on driving. But I don't know. I just wanted to get out there, get back to it. So, anyways, guys, I just wanted to say good morning. If you haven't already, please like and subscribe, help me out there. What I want to do is I want to just show kind of my journey, just kind of get out there and see a little bit of the Southwest, what I go through on an everyday basis. I'm on the Family Dollar account with Warner, and just kind of want to show you guys that are interested in this account. Guys, what I do, and so I'll show some video of me unloading this week. You know, just kind of showing you my route. You know, no two stores are ever the same. You never know where they're gonna send you. But right now we're headed north in Arizona on the Highway 60. Miles from home, you just gotta keep trucking. So opposite side of the river. For you all that never been out here, you cross the bridge, Arizona's on one side, Nevada's on the other. It's fairly new. I don't know how many years it's been open, but as far as I was told, it's semi-new. I guess back a long time ago, you used to drive across the dam itself, but I don't know. I've only been out this way for the last, I would say, couple years, and that's how it's always been, so over the bridges. But it's kind of a windy day today. I wanted to get out here early before the wind really started to pick up. So I think right up here is where it gets a little sketchy. But anyways, just wanted to show you guys. The dam is actually off to my right down below. But here's the main bridge. I think it's called the Pat Tillman. So, but the wind ain't too bad today, or it's supposed to be. I thought it would be a little bit worse, but seems to be not blowing too bad. I could feel it a little bit, but nothing like I was expecting. And here's Nevada. I was born and raised here and love every bit of it. I currently live in Arizona right now. And I'll tell you, I miss Nevada like no other. So, anyways, I have a couple questions for you guys. One, what kind of music you guys listen to when you're out on these long road trips? I seem to catch myself flipping to new stuff a lot just because, you know, XM radio and seems to play the same stuff just like every other radio station after a while. So I just, you know, you guys, we buy XM radio because we're tired of hearing our local radios play the same stuff. And if you're in the car too long, it's the same shit. So I don't know. Whatever. So, let me know if you guys have any good channels that outside of, you know, the country, you know, stations that I normally listen to. But I know they're changing them up all the time. So, if you guys have anything that you actually listen to, let me know. I'm always down to listen to new stuff and get into it. Get some. Coming up here is going to be Boulder City. The outskirts of it. For all you gamblers out there. We're about 20 miles outside of Las Vegas. But Boulder City's the first city you come into coming in out of the Arizona way from the south. And it's, I never been there. You know, growing up in Nevada, gambling just wasn't our thing. I mean, even as I got older, you know, you have your phases that you go in and want to check out a casino and gamble a little bit. And I don't know. Everybody says you always lose, but not necessarily. I mean, you go out there and you blow your money. What they call chasing is, you know, you lose, let's say you lose $100, and so you want to make that $100 back, so you go to the ATM and go get you another chunk of money, try to win that $100 back. When you lose that, you go to the ATM again and you go get you some more money to try to win back the money that you lost. They call that chasing. That right there will get you in a lot of trouble. Get you divorced. Get you in a lot of trouble. So, you go out there, have a good time. like to win. And just to go out there to have a good time and give you something to do. It's a lot of fun. As long as you're responsible about it. Outside of that, like I said, you get yourself in trouble. I've had a couple really, really lucky days. I used to bartend a long time ago, and when I used to get off of work, I would throw a $20 bill in a machine and max bet it. I'd usually play, like poker. Day I hit the button max bet twice, and you bet your ass I didn't hit a royal flush. The very next day I threw in a $20 in another machine and hit four aces with a two, and that won me another $1,100. $1,200. So in 2 days I won like almost $4,000. And I don't ever expect to do that ever again in my life, but it's a story that I like to tell, and I just told you. So get over it. Outside of that, we are about 20 minutes outside of Las Vegas, so I will be back and kind of show you Vegas. All right, guys, welcome to Las Vegas. For all you that's never been here, it's a lot of fun downtown. I've been there a few times. Unfortunately, I was there during that mass shooting in 2017. And the funny thing is, that's how I got to Arizona. I met a girl out there, and at the concert itself, and ended up dating right after, and moving there in 2019. Yeah, so I've been there about a year and a half in Phoenix, but yeah, Vegas is a fun place, man. If you guys have never been, definitely down on the strip, I'd recommend staying at any of the hotels. You can usually find really good deals out there depending on the time of the year and in advance, just like anything else. But a lot of things to do here in Vegas for all you NASCAR fans, and pretty much anything you want to do, you can do it here. And also, you guys like to go out. Nevada doesn't have a curfew for drinking. You can drink all the way 24/7. You know, they don't shut it down at 2 a.m., 4 a.m., or midnight. It doesn't stop. So other than that, it's a cool little city. I like it. I've never lived here. I'm actually from the northern Nevada part, but out here it's a little different. You know, it's a lot bigger. It's Nevada's biggest city. And look at that. You don't ever see that very often. A truck pulling a bunch of statued animals. Now, I'm a hunter, so I enjoy seeing stuff like that. But you don't see that every day.